parade, because that's what he does. He brings this, he brings that, he brings that, he brings that, he brings that. And when you are overwhelmed, the need to pray will not be there.
That's right.
Going to church will not be there. Mm. Doctor said this. Mm. This said that. Mm. Friend said that. Mm. This said that. You know, from family members, all this and that, and that and that. But let me tell you today that that is not the will and purpose of God concerning you.
Come on,
right.
Come on.
Right. That's right. The
Bible says, whose report are we going to look?
Amen.
Whose report?
Good news.
Is it that of the doctor? Or if your family member said, you know, if this has been from our generation, from our four mothers, and all that, and because you are part of the lineage, because
that's
you are part of the blood relation, you're going to have that symptom. I'm telling you that the word of God does not say that it, because of your faith in Christ, because of your belief, because you know.
Yes, he did. Say it again.
Come on, sir.
That is cut. You are in a different dispensation.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because of your faith.
Yes.
Bible says, you know, our faith in God. Our faith in God is very great. The scripture says, even so faith, if it has no works, is dead, being alone. It is good to have faith, but we're going to accompany that faith with works.
Yes.
We're praying in this church. We are praying as individuals. We need to pray more. We need to start our prayers. Don't sit back and say, well, Pastor Ben is praying for me. You're going to pray.
Yes.
You're going to pray. I'm just telling the young people in our midst here, the unmarried ones, you know, and even the married, that you need to begin to lay the foundation of prayer in your life.
Amen.
Yes.
It's true.
Yes.
You begin to lay the foundation of prayer because your children will see your prayer life.
Yeah.
You know, your future life or your, you know, home is going to base on prayer. And if you are building on that which is not a prayer, I'm telling you, there'll be a time of shaking it.
Yes.
There'll be a time of trial.
Yes.
There'll be a time of tribulation. That your faith will be questioned.
That's true.
Right. Right.
It's coming.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. It's just enough. Bible says, even if I've in faith, being alone is dead. The NIV put it this way. In the same way, faith by itself, if it's not accompanied with, by action, is dead.
Right.
Our faith should be accompanied with prayers. Our faith should be seen with prayers. Our faith should be, you know, always in a guided with prayers. It is not enough for us to believe God and say, well, God, you know. Yes, God knows everything. We're going to do something about it. What are you doing about that situation? What is your portion? Are you talking to God about it? Are you praying now? You got to pray. Praise God. Bible says that, you know, if it's our coming with faith, it's dead. Just as our body, without the Spirit in us, is dead.
Yes, that's right.
What makes the difference? Is the Spirit of God in you?
That's right.
Why? You know, why are we different from non-believers? Why are you different from non-believers? Because of the Spirit of God in you.
Mm.
If the body, if you remove the Spirit of God from us, we are unbelievers.
That's right.
As well.
That's so true.
And if our faith is not accompanied by prayers, Satan will kick us. He will kick us anyhow. We need to pray, brothers and sisters.
Amen.
I can tell you, I've seen for the past, you know, 3 months or thereabout, I've seen what the enemy is doing, the more you fight him, the more you fight him back.
True.
The more you fight it, they will fight it back. But don't be afraid, okay? That's not for you to say, no, no, I'm not going to do anything about it. You got to be on the offense. You got to put into it that you want. Don't say, well, I'm going to wait when it comes out. No way. It's going to come. And when it comes, probably the way you may not even know how it's going to, you know, get to you. So we have to be on prayer. Amen.
Amen.
This day, I want to tell us, you know, how we can master that being. How we can master Satan.
Come on.
And I want to say to us that, you know, God has made us to be what we are. Paul was saying, he said, I am what I am. You must believe what God says you are.
That's right.
You must know that God has made you to be somebody.
Yes. Yes.
And don't allow Satan to change that.
Come on.
Our destiny is sure.
Amen.
Our goal is sure.
Amen.
Like in the U.S. when they say the state of the union is strong. Our faith in God is strong. In your faith and your destiny is sure.
Come on.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bible says, let's look at the scripture. Let's look at one of our sisters in the Bible. Hannah. Mm. It's an example of Hannah. Bible says, you know, even her adversary was, you know, she'll mock her to the extent where she'll provoke her to anger. Bible says that to the point that, you know, when this lady, you know, Penina or whatever you call her name, I believe that in the first, you know, pregnancy, when she, you know, she probably the first pregnancy with her opinion of failures, whatever, you know, she would just come before her and say, and, you know, just to mock her and just to make her life miserable. Yeah. But, you know, while the devil was using her to do all those, she, you know, she forgot that the same company that manufactured pencil, the same company that manufactured eraser, and also wipe out or pressure fluid, that what God has already written, you know, God erased it. Bible says God, you know, closed her wound. The same God who closed her wound must open the wound. Bible says Hannah went into prayer. Bible says Hannah decided her destiny. She knew her position in God. She knew that though her wound was closed, God is able to pass that wound. Yeah. I said now. I said now.
You're going to die.
Hello, confirm. Come on.
As the guy looked at himself, he said, my goodness, God, I've served you.
Yes, yes, come on.
I've done everything.
Yes.
Yes. What would you say I should die? I shall not die. Yes. I said, I shall not die.
Amen.
David said, I shall not die. Amen. I will live to see the glory of God.
Amen.
That is not my portion. That is not my portion.
Amen.
Right? Bible says, Hezekiah prayed. Hezekiah prayed. He knows that God is a God of life.
Amen.
The God that gives life.
Yeah.
And he said, God, I will not die.
Yes.
Tell me why should I, Lord? Bible says God answers his prayer.
Yes, amen.
Pray, change destiny.
Yes.
Prayer, change situation. Yes. Prayer can turn things around.
Come on.
Yes.
When our hope seems lost, when you think everything is gone, God can change things around.
Yes.
You know, some of us will look at ourselves and say, well, all my friends, they have done this, or they have done that, they have done this. Let me tell you, what the Lord is about to do, what the Lord is about to do,
hallelujah.
Oh my goodness,
yes.
If only God can open your eyes to see,
Jesus.
He was saying, I'll tell you for the ladies.
You see? Oh, come on, let's see.
If only God can open your eyes to see what he's about to do,
say thank you.
He was saying, thank you for the lady, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Because God knows the best.
Yes.
He knows the right time.
Yes. That's right.
You know, Peter and I, I call it Penna now, Penanda. You know, that's the lady's name. You know, she has Huffini and Penanda. And she thought she was on top, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, you know, Hannah, come on, Hannah, what are you doing today? You know, and believe me, Bible says the only one child, with all the delays, with all the time, the only one child somewhere, oh my goodness, is over more than even the two children. And by the grace of God, we can see the fruits of what one child somewhere did. That's the fruit of
Hannah. Amen. Yes, sir.
God is a wonderful God.
Yes.
Don't look at a situation and use others to compare
yourself. Hey, come on.
Because, like you said, you know, that's the biggest mistake you will ever make.
Yes.
Hey.
Because our God, you know, I tell you that Jesus is your standard.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Jesus
come
is
on.
Your standard.
Hallelujah.
It's not that your friend or your colleague, you know, in a workplace or whatever, your neighbor,
amen,
that has a big house and you have a small one.